What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video, and this video is going to be our first JavaScript tutorial where we are going to see how to create this random color generator using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. I had explained every single step, so make sure to watch the tutorial completely. Also, I will keep uploading more awesome tutorials related to web development, so make sure you are subscribed to this channel. By the way, guys, this YouTube channel is in collaboration with Newton School. You can check out their website. The link to their website is in description. And also, let's check out what exactly is Newton School.
Let's see about what is Newton School. So Newton School is a platform which prepares you for your career in tech. It has courses designed for working professionals, freshers, and even people with no tech background. That means even if you are from a non-tech background, you can also join this platform and can make your career in tech. Newton School will first train you for 6 months and will help you become an amazing full stack developer. Now you might be thinking whether this platform is free or not. So let me tell you a cool thing, that you don't have to pay Newton School anything until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. I repeat, guys, you don't have to pay Newton School anything for the 6 months full stack developer training until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. And I think this is something that all of us should expect from any training program. So must check out their website for more information. I will provide the link in description. Now on their website, you can see they have something called the Launchpad. So Launchpad is basically an initiative taken by Newton School for people who want to start their coding journey from scratch, and that too absolutely free of cost. This video of mine will be also available on the Launchpad section. You can go there anytime and you can learn basics of programming languages, you can practice quizzes, and even you can do assignments. These all things are completely free to do. So let's start coding our random color generator. I had opened the output here. And we will start with our markup. So let's see what we need in our markup. So we need an element that will show the current color, and also we need a button that will generate that random color. Okay, so let's create them. I will include them in one container. Okay, so I will create a container for them. So I will use div tag for that, and I will give it a class of container, and it will contain the element that will show our current color. So I will use h2 for that element, and I will give it a class of current color. And inside that, at the initial stage, I want the color to be black. Okay, so I will give the hex code of black, that is 000000. Okay, and now let's create the button that will generate our random color. So I will use button tag, and I will give it a class of generate btn. And I will write generate random color inside it. Okay, okay, so we are done with our markup. Let's quickly style our elements. So as always, we will start with centering our container within body. So let's center our container. So first I will give background color to our body, and let's say black for now. Okay, and also to center the container, I will use the display flex method. So let's first remove the default browser margin. I will give margin 0 to body, and now let's use the display flex method to center our container within body. Okay, so I will write display flex, and I will write justify content center to align our container horizontally center, and align item center to align our container vertically center. Okay, so basically we also have to give height of 100 vh. Okay, so now you can see our container is in center of our body. Okay,
So let's style our current color. I will target that element. Okay. And I want the color to be white. And I want to align it in center. So I will use text align center. I will give it a font size of 50 pixel. And also I want the font family to be impact. Okay. And also I want to give it a text shadow, basically a black text shadow, so that no matter what the background color is, our current color should be visible properly. Okay. So I will give it a text shadow of 003 pixel and black in color. Okay. So basically this combination will make our current color visible no matter what the background color will be. Okay, so it will now look properly in all the background colors. Okay, now let's style our generate button. So I will target that and I want padding of 16 pixel from top and bottom and 32 pixel from left and right. I want the background color to be transparent. I want the color to be white. I want border 3 pixel solid and white in color. Also, I want the text transform to be capitalized. I want the font size to be 30 pixel. I want the cursor to be pointer. And similarly, what we have done here, we will also do the same thing in our generate button, so that our button is completely and properly visible no matter what the background color is. So I will copy the shadow from here and I will paste it here, and we need box shadow here, not text shadow. So now we are done with our styling. Now let's create the generate function in JavaScript that will basically generate the random colors. Okay, so let's start writing JavaScript. So inside JavaScript, let me get all the required elements that we will need in our JavaScript code. Okay, so the very first element that we will need is our current color element, because we will also change its text. As you can see, when I am clicking on generate random color, the text of this element is also changing. Okay, so we are doing this with JavaScript. So I will need that element. So let me get that element. I will create a variable. And let's say the variable name is current color, and I will use document dot query selector method to get our element. And just like we use CSS selector, you can get elements in JavaScript using document dot query selector, and here you can write this CSS selector to get that element. Okay, so I will use dot current color to get that current color element. So I have stored the element in current color variable. We also need our body tag, because we will change its color. Okay, so let's get our body tag. I will store our body element in this variable, that is body lm. Okay, so again I will use document.query selector and I will target our body element. Okay, so we have stored our body element in body lm variable. Now at last we need our generate button. So I will store our generate button into generate btn variable, and again I will use document.query selector. Okay, so we got our all the elements that is required in our JavaScript code. Okay, so the very first thing that I will do in JavaScript after getting all the elements is I will give an initial background color to our body element. Okay, so let me remove the background color from our CSS, because we want to change the background color through JavaScript. Okay, I just gave background color to our body tag in CSS so that we can properly see our styling of our elements. Okay, now let's give an initial color to our body element. So let's write body lm.style.background color. And the initial color is basically what we have in our current color element. So we will get that by using current color dot inner text. Okay. So basically, whatever will be the text inside our current color element will be equal to our background color. We have currently hashtag 000000, and that is what we are getting as our background color of our body element. Okay. So we have set the initial background color. Now let's write a function to generate random colors. Okay. So I will add an event listener to our generate button. And the event is basically click event. So I will write click in the first parameter. And the second parameter is basically the function that you want to run when this event will happen on this element. Okay. So whenever we will click on our generate button, this function will run. Okay. So you can see basically, if I will write console.log running. Now when I will click on this button, there will be a log in console. So you can see I had clicked the button, and now let me open the console. Okay, so let me click on the button, and you can see there is running logging into console. Okay, so it is working fine. And now let's write our code to generate random colors. So the very first thing that I will do is basically I will create a variable for our random color, and let's leave it blank for now. And also I will create a variable that will store the required characters. Okay, so understand this point. Basically, in any given hex code, there are fixed number of characters. Okay, so let's say we have a hex code. Let's say we have FF7A00. Okay, so we have F here, we have 7 here, we have A here, and we have 0 here. So basically, hex code is a combination of some fixed characters. Okay, so those characters are basically 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, so any given hex code is basically combination of these characters. So we need this character to generate a random hex code, or you can say a random color. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is basically I will create a loop that will run 6 times, and each and every time the loop will run, we will get a random letter from this string, and we will concatenate that to our random color variable. Okay, so at last, when the loop will finish, we will get a combination of 6 characters from this string, and that will create a valid hex code that we can use as our background color of our body element. Okay, so let me create the loop, and inside the loop we have to get a random letter from this character string, and we have to concatenate that letter into our random color. Okay, so I will write random color equal to random color plus we have to get a random letter from our characters string. Okay, so we will do that by generating a random index. Okay, so I will use characters, and we have to get a random index so that we can get a random letter on the basis of that index. Okay, so we have to generate a random number here. Okay, so we will use math.random function here. And since we have 16 characters here, so we need a random value that ranges from 0 to 16 that we can use in our index. Okay, so basically we need a random number from 0 to 16 so that we can use that in our index. And since we are using that random number in our index, let's say that random number is 1. So we will get the letter at first index, that is 1. Okay, and let's say if we got a random number, that is 5, so we will get the letter at fifth index, that is 0 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so that is 5. So we have to generate a random number between 0 to 16. So let me write math.random, and since we want a value that ranges between 0 to 16, therefore I will multiply the math.random function to 16. Okay. Now the random number that we might get from this can be a decimal. Okay, so we don't want a decimal number because index value with decimal number are not valid. Okay, so we need an integer value here. So what I will do here is I will use math.floor method. Okay, so I will write math.floor and I will pass our math.random into 16 expression into our math.floor parameter. Okay, so what math.floor will do, basically it will round the number that we'll get from here downwards to the nearest integer. Okay, so let's say we got 5.6 here, so math.floor will round 5.6 downwards to the nearest integer, that is 5. Okay, so if we will get 6.5, math.floor will convert it to 6. Okay, so we will get a fixed integer. Okay, and now we can successfully generate a random number, or you can say random integer, that will pass as an index, and we can successfully get a letter from this character's string. So let's console.log our random color and see what we are getting when we are running our loop. Okay, so let me open the console. Let me clear the console first. And now let's click on generate random button and see what we got. So what is happening here is that we have seen that we have an empty string as our random color for now. And when our loop is running, we are concatenating our random color with a random letter from the character's string. Okay. So the very first time when the loop has run, we got a random letter from our character string, that is 9. So 9 is getting concatenated with empty string, that is our random color, and the resultant string is 9. The second time our loop is running, we are again getting a random letter from our character string, and this time it's 0. And our random color was 9. And now 0 is getting concatenating with 9, and the same thing goes on till we get 6 characters into our random color. Okay, so let me remove the console.log from here. And the good news is that we have generated our random color successfully, but the point to notice here is that in every hex code there is a hashtag before all those 6 digits. Okay, so we have to concatenate that hashtag into our random color. So what I will do is basically I will change the inner text of our current color element, and I will concatenate a hashtag with our random color. Okay, so now let's check if it's working or not. So I'm clicking the button and you can see the current color is changing, and we have our hashtag here and we have our random color here. Okay, so it is resulting in a valid hex code. Okay, so you can see whenever I will click the button, a random hex code is generating in our current color element. Okay, so now we also want to change the background color as we click on our button. So let's give background color to our body element, and I will copy the same thing and I will paste it here. Okay, so now you can see when I will click the generate random color, the background color of our body is changing, and also we are getting that random color here in our current color element. Okay, so you can see I am clicking the generate random color. Let me open the output in full screen, and you can see if I will inspect, you can see the background color is basically 6F1AD4. Okay, so basically what we have here. Now you can see we have created random color generator using JavaScript. So this was it guys. I hope you guys liked this random color generator. And if you have any doubts related to any step, just feel free to comment your doubts below. Also, I will keep posting awesome tutorials related to web development. So make sure you are subscribed to the channel. Don't forget to check out Newton School. The link to their website is in description. And I will see you guys in the next video.